Hello, dear students. Today we are going to do an interesting activity and we will be exploring convex and concave polygons using GeoGebra. So, what are polygons? So, we have understood that polygons are simple closed curve made up of only line segments. Now, we would be understanding how we can know which polygons are convex polygons and which polygons are concave polygons. So there are different ways of looking at it. So let me first draw a polygon. So you can see that A, B, C, D, E is a closed figure and it is formed by joining line segments. So now you see that, how do we name it? We see how many sides are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's a pentagon. And all the sides are not equal. So it's an irregular pentagon. So this is one thing. Now we need to know whether this polygon is a convex polygon or a concave polygon. So what we are going to do is, we will observe the type of interior angles. Okay, so let us see this first interior angle. What do you think? Is it less than 180 degrees or not? Yes, it is less than 180 degrees. And what about this? Yes, it is more than 90 degrees, but it is less than 180 degrees. So we are going to check each interior angle of the given polygon. And we will see that all the interior angles, they are less than 180 degrees. So in this case, if all the angles, interior angles, they are less than 180 degrees, then we call this polygon as convex polygon, right? Okay, let us now draw one more polygon. So I'm choosing the line segment tool and trying to make another polygon. Here you can see that okay, let me make it like this. Okay, here also you can see that GHIJF, this is a closed figure which is formed by joining line segments, and here also it's a pentagon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides are there, and it's an irregular pentagon because all sides are not equal. So here, if we observe the interior angles, each interior angle, let us see what is the observation. Is this angle less than 180 degrees? Yes. Is this angle less than 180 degrees? Yes. Is this angle less than 180 degrees? Yes. Okay, let us check the next one. Yes. Okay, now you tell about this. Is this interior angle less than 180 degree? Of course not. It is a reflex angle. So here, if we find any angle which is more than 180 degrees, then such a polygon is called a concave polygon. So we have understood that one way of checking whether the given polygon is a concave polygon or a convex polygon. So what you need to do is, you need to check the interior angles. So if we check the interior angles, all the interior angles you need to notice. If all the interior angles are less than 180 degrees, then we call them as convex polygon. And if all the interior angles, after checking, you see that one angle at least is more than 180 degrees, then we call it as a concave polygon. I hope it is clear to you. This is one way of checking whether the given polygon is convex or concave. Now, I am going to share with you the second way. You just look into this and try to draw the diagonals. So I'm starting from the point A. Okay, let me use another tool. Let me take the line segment from here. This will be easier. So I've drawn one diagonal, another diagonal from E also, from D. Already one is drawn. Let me draw another one. Now you see that from all the vertices, we have drawn the diagonals. Observe closely then that in this convex polygon, all the diagonals, when you are making, they lie in the interior of the polygon. Let us do the same in the concave polygon and see what is the observation. I'm trying to start from J. Okay, I can draw this one diagonal. Okay, I can draw this. This is already there. From F, and then from G, already drawn. Okay, from G, if I try to see here, this diagonal, let me change the color. So you will notice that this diagonal is outside this polygon, boundary of the polygon. So you will get to notice that it is not a convex polygon, but it is a concave polygon. So this is another way of checking whether the given polygon is a convex or a concave polygon. Okay, let me share with you the third way of checking whether the given polygon is a convex polygon or a concave polygon. Okay, so what we try to do is we take up certain points. Say for example, we mark two points in the interior of the polygon. And we try to join it. Then you see that these two points, after joining, the line segment is in the interior. So wherever you take the two points, it should be true for all the locations, you know. So you can check this by joining, by taking a pair of points in the interior of the given polygon. So here you notice that in case of a convex polygon, when you take two points and join them, all these line segments, they are in the interior of this convex polygon. Now let us see in the other case what happens in a concave polygon. Say I'm marking here. So you will say that, okay, if I join O and P, I am getting a line segment which is in the interior of this polygon. But, my dear students, you notice if I take the points here, it should be true for all set of points which you can possibly take in the interior. If I take the points Q and R, you see these two points are in the interior of this polygon and I join them. See what happens. I'm just now changing the color of this so that you can understand this better. So you will notice that portion of this line segment is outside this polygon. So this is one indication that such a polygon is a concave polygon. So I hope you have understood the three different ways of checking the convex or a concave polygon. So practice and explore using this software and just share your observations with me. Thank you and have a nice day.